So I'm interviewing, your name is, the first name I'm not quite sure, Mehmet or?
Mehran Tavakoli.
Mehran Kesh.
Yes.
And you're from Iran?
Yeah.
And you've been in Belgium or outside Iran, I think I've been told, for about 39 years?
Yes, 39
years. 39 years. And you've developed some very interesting technologies, primarily in the direction of space, and as sort of... spin-offs from that, you've also developed technologies in relation to health care, energy, and things like that.
Yeah. So
what actually got you started in
technology? I was born in the field of radiation.
Right.
My father used to be part of the X-ray,
right,
of the international company, and that's how I got involved in it.
Okay. And if I remember correctly, you trained in the United Kingdom?
Yes, I'm a nuclear physicist for England.
Okay.
I trained in London.
Trained in London. Okay. So, your technology, as I understand it, is safe energy. In other words, it doesn't actually emit.
It's a plasma.
It's a plasma.
Plasma is always safe.
Plasma is always safe.
Yes.
And so, this is always a very unusual way of looking at it. I see not many people in the world who are doing similar technologies. I recently saw, I think through your forum, that an American group are also investigating this technology.
The American group are investigating plasma technology for energy. Part of it is our technology.
Yes, that's as I understood it, which is very interesting and also serves as a backup. Now, when I speak to people about your technology, the number one question they ask is, where is the proof? What would you say to these people?
Our proof is enough. People who are walking, and you've seen the video this afternoon and the presentation, the torch we've shown, the proof is there. What you see with the space technology has been proven by the other government. And secondly, we have given our technology to governments to prove it. So now, handful of nations plus, and by next few days, half of world population governments will have the proof. We don't give it to them, they call and say, can we have the technology, because they know it's correct.
Yes.
So we don't listen to what people say. This technology is not for the people at the moment, it's for the government.
It's for the governments. Yeah, that's right. Certainly there's a lot of interest in your technology from people I've been talking to. We move on to the health aspects. Now, if I've understood it correctly from what I've seen today, you're using plasma as a kind of energy field to treat diseases.
We are using plasma to transfer information.
Transferring information, okay. Now, I'm familiar with resonance therapy.
I don't believe in it.
So. You don't believe in resonance therapy? Where we use resonance to basically vibrate molecules to...
That is in a matter level. I don't work in matter, I work in plasma.
Ah, okay.
So when you work in the plasma, you understand resonance is a lot of nonsense. So,
because I mean we have had a lot of positive effects using resonance.
Yes, you get rid of, but in a way, it's not the way the universe works. We look at the way the universe works.
Right.
There is no resonance in the universe. It's the interaction of plasmas.
Oh.
Resonance is the attributes of matter.
Yes.
And plasma does not contain matter, unless it's on its boundary when it becomes matter, and that's irrelevant anyway, because we never use it.
Okay, so now you've talked about applications in the health world, treating diseases like multiple sclerosis and cancer, and from what I've been hearing, you've been having a lot of success in treating such diseases.
We are not treating, we are learning for this.
Or investigating.
We are investigating new approaches in reversing the diseases, what we call diseases, although
yes,
the reality is magnetic, gravitational fields which have moved from their position.
Yes.
And what we see is not a miracle, it's just understanding how the universe works.
Yeah, okay. Now, one question which I've been thinking about. This therapy can be used for health to treat a lot of people. How much interest has been shown by the medical...
A lot. We get a lot of our volunteers, our doctors' referrals from all over the world.
Okay.
Even this afternoon you saw there are quite a number of doctors in the audience.
Yes.
There are about 30% of 70-80, they were all medical doctors and in that level. And if you've seen, a lot of them give you, they've been giving me files of their patients that they want us to look after. Because there is no, what do you call it, there is no, nothing available to help them at the moment in the world of medicine. So they offer, they come to us to see if we can find a solution in the space technology for us to learn.
Yes.
We are not here to help people, we are very open about it. We are here through the help of the people to find ways to be able to help man in the space in the future.
Mm.
And it's amazing how many people in the way of trying to get helping themselves are allowing us to develop new technologies for the space technology.
Yes. Now we move on to the space technology. Which this is also a subject which has always interested me. You've developed one or two or many of these spacecraft.
We develop systems.
You develop the systems or whatever. These technologies seem to be very unique in the way they work. You talk in your forum about how backward NASA is in their technologies, but today you hinted that maybe NASA is coming around
all
to
the
agreeing.
Space agencies are coming around because it makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Since we start putting videos directly into the space agencies, they
yeah.
realize the reality of what the situation is. Soon you will see change in a lot of space agencies following the new method, which is actually how the universe moves and finds its position. That's
yes.
all we do. We haven't discovered, we haven't developed anything yet. We understand the concept of the motion in the universe, and that's all we do, we repeat it.
Mm-hmm. I noticed that from the point where you started to disclose, I think your second meeting for the governments, suddenly NASA starts announcing that they can also do faster than light or fast to travel to Mars and whatever, that suddenly they're saying that these technologies could be possible. Is there a direct relation?
Of course it is, because after our 21st of September presentation here,
yes,
we received a communication from NASA who they would like to discuss new developments.
Right.
And that is in progress.
Okay, because you also mentioned that it was impossible within NASA to see your website. Has
yes,
that improved
that.
Now?
Yeah, it's still the same.
Now, you've also announced that other countries like Africa, I think in Sierra Leone you've been starting training, and other countries, Latin America I believe, are now starting their own space agencies. Can you tell us something about that?
We are transferring our knowledge to governments. I mean, today's meeting you were present.
Yes.
The officials from the government of Thailand requested to be here themselves. And we very graciously asked them if they would like to receive the transfer of technology data, USB stick,
yes.
in private, or if you don't mind, we can do it, present them in public.
Yes.
And as you saw it, officials wanted to be known officially in public that they received it, and they handed over the key in public in the public lecture to them, and they immediately knew that in position of technology, and they already, during the presentation of the morning, they received that they would like to bring their scientists here next month, a large number of them, to analyze the whole technology that they can immediately implement it. And this has all happened since this morning while you were sitting in
yes,
there.
Yes, yes.
So governments know what we do. We care what people do, because people can push their governments to accept the technology and develop it, but the ambassadorial group which were here today,
mm-hmm.
They're all doctors and top scientists of the country. They knew, and they were here before, so they could have asked us to deliver the key to their embassy, but they wanted to be here, publicly known that they are in position.
Right.
And as you saw, it is all recorded that they received a full technology transfer in public.
Yes, that's. I find this is very encouraging that your technology is being taken seriously now.
Well, of course, yeah, because they know.
I know. I'm sure you've been waiting a long time for this to happen.
No, it's a progress of accepting and understanding. Some of our patents are on the internet, so they have their scientists reading it. They know what it's involved. Governments don't make move at this high level, at pharmaceutical level, without instruction of internally with the foreign office internally and the scientific internally in their country, analyzing the technology. Watch the space for the next Friday, not this Friday. Read our websites next Friday. You will see how far we've got.
On your website, you've talked about offering space trips to the Moon, to Mars. How far are you getting on this?
Now the governments will do it for you. We don't need to do it.
Ah, okay. So the Keshe Foundation will not be offering...
We don't need to. We give the technology to all your governments. It's theirs to put it in motion and do it next year.
Okay. So you think this will be happening soon? And
2013, 2014, number of nations should be ready to work.
Ah. Okay. That's very, very interesting. When do you think these nations will start announcing this publicly?
It's already public. We put it on our forum. If you look at the Italian link on our forum,
yes,
in the same link, in the same paragraph as I have announced we transferred, official of the Italian government confirms the receipts of the key by its government.
Yes.
And again, in the same link, they ask us to contact the embassy for transport development. This we have come to an agreement with the Italians to do things in an open way and a transparent way.
Yes.
And the transparency sits on our website. And the way we ask questions openly in public from them,
yes,
because the Italian public wants it, and they answer us directly, openly on the public on our forum. It's the first time a government has done such a move,
mm-hmm,
to be so open, because this is the beauty of what we do with them. Straightforwardness operation.
Now, I think the public media has generally ignored your technology so far.
We don't care. The public media doesn't count. The bottom line, where we are now, counts.
We all know the situation in Japan,
yeah,
with the radiation problems there, which concerns a lot of people worldwide. I've heard that you have a technology. In fact, you were talking about it today.
We have handed the technology to the government of Japan.
Yes.
And we have given them full support if they want to develop it. This is happening past 7 days, six, 7 days.
Yes.
So we have to wait for the Japanese government to take the step in how they want to bring their scientists.
But the technology has the capability of rendering neutral the radiation?
You don't render neutral, you create contamination control systems.
So if I understand it from this, you're saying that you can basically encapsulate...
More or less.
Encapsulate the radiation and prevent it from getting out.
That's what we can do.
Is that some kind of like force field?
Or no, it's just a gravitational magnetic field system.
Okay. Do you have ability to decontaminate?
Yes, it's been done.
It's been done? So you could decontaminate, like...
We don't do it anymore. It's not the government.
Well, whoever's doing it, yes. I'm talking about whoever is doing this there. I'm just saying what capabilities...
Yeah, how they're capable of doing, yes.
So you'd be able to decontaminate the ground and
it
things
can
like
be
that.
Done, but that's in the future.
That's in the future. Yeah, then I'd like to thank you a lot for this interview, and it's been very interesting, and I wish you the very best of your technology.
Thank you very much. Thanks for your time.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.